mobilize armies without fighting is the best of skills.
The art of war.
Razor.
Dangerous.
Forward.
I'm like a step in the razor. Don't you watch my size? I'm dangerous. Dangerous. I'm like a step in the razor. Don't you watch my size? I'm dangerous.
Stepping razor. Mutabaaruka. Art of war. Listen, Jamaica. And this is the art of war. Way, way on. Way, way on. Yeah. Sing it, sing it. Representing from our family. The blood of African kings run up in our veins. Here in the Jamaica, rebellious offspring. Muta got a warrior spirit inside. From that time, we can't him. And this a warrior spirit inside. It come from every shackle and chain. On the Shaka Zulu, Pitney, Nkuma, Pitney, Steppin' Razor, Pitney. And the art of war every Thursday. Hey, look how many years them whip with. That's what the whip and one microchip with. We tell them Babylon style of it with. War it out until we get with victory. Hey, them fight my brother and sister. When we are dancing, say we move sinister. I know we're listening. Mutabaaruka, chant the culture. Chase the vultures away. On the Shaka Zulu, Pitney, Nkuma. Pitney, Kunta Kinte, Pitney. It's like Malcolm and Martin and Marcus and Fiery. Taurus, you see, right there, represent for Mutabaaruka. The art of war. Sure. Rasta.
When a youth fails, it's always put down to personal problems. But one cannot ignore the social system and the effect it can have on an individual. It's all about the youths. It's all about the youths. The youth them of today. Their role in this society, the part they're gonna play. It's all about the youths. The youth them of today. The future for tomorrow. They have to lead the way. Too much unemployment, too much violence and the crime. Too much are we youths are in a prison.
Yeah, alright. Thank you, engineer. Yeah, we want to say hello to the ones them. Today is Thursday. And this is the it was 2 years ago on a Thursday. Exactly. We started this program 2 years ago. Steppin' Razor, the art of war. So we're there for 2 years now. And we say we go and give thanks to all the people them who stay with me and listen to me and who go buy phone, we have radio, we plug in at them ears and stop listen to them bars and I do them work still, but still I listen to Steppin' Razor. Why you know all the taxi man them who when them a drive and them people them say, I hope you have radio, they turn it upon Steppin' Razor, you know, it's been nah, take your taxi. We want to heal up the people them. We want to heal up all the man them who listen to it and stop pissing the light post them for rotting down the people them light posts. Because them hear Mutabaaruka say, boy, you want to say, well, we acidic, you know, and if you got keep pissing upon the light post them, it have a rotten down the light post them. Because them make the man them start put up concrete light posts, you know. Okay, we want to heal up all the people them who sit down and listen to it. And before we forget, we want to heal up Gee Whiz restaurant, is a veggie restaurant now, in a Treasure Beach, a long time. Treasure Beach, we have vegetarian restaurant, you know. We tell the restaurant, then we have pork on one side and veggie on the next side. You understand? We want a restaurant to have vegetarian right through. And we hope a vegetarian right through. We have to Jackie down there, have a wonderful time without, you know, watching, you know. Okay, so one place, one of all the people, them. down at Treasure Beach right now who are listening to it, and in at the Jeewee's restaurant are listening to it. Yeah, this is the remix.
What is? You are listening to Mutabaaruka. Provoking, always smoking, lyrics like a bazooka. You are listening to Mutabaaruka.
At what point it became, or he became aware that this gentleman was about to come to Jamaica? Was he traveling here on the invitation of the organizers of the $1 million million. Well, it's really $1 million. It's $4 million.
You are listening to Mutabaaruka.
The Art of War. I listen to Aine Kamuzi remix dub style Ilangole Ride.
And every man don't win the penitentiary. Hang in the country for my brother Randy. Growing your vegetable elegantly. If you love his majesty, we couldn't touch you with no negromancy. All the leave if I don't see. And every rain soft and dumb is a
Angoli ride that all out the pan, believe you me. You know, say from Aine Kamuzi to Busy Signal, yes, brand new Busy Signal.
Me give them where them want. Me give them. Me give not go give them. But if it's a fearful look a job, me we give them. If I cook here now, if I crack, me not go give them. But if it's a food fist up a job, me we give them. Yeah, them a try step to me, but me no see them. Them can't reach me level, so go tell them no fi pretend. Don't be officious in the good book it written. While them killing up themselves, me just sit down and cut me ten. Me give them where them want, me give them. Me give them where them want, me give them. Me give them where them want, me give them. Me give them, trust me, me give them. Me give them where them want, me give them. Me give them where them want, me give them. Me give them where them want, me give them. Me give them, trust me, me give them. Yeah, them want roots, me give them. Them want culture.
Yeah. Busy signal, I do a spin off a burning spear tune. May I tell you? Yes, busy. You're busy with that one, yeah. Easy style, you know. Dub style. Rubber dub style. Believe you me.
Them no one known. Trouble me not give them. No sadness, no problem me not give them. Me give them where them want, me give them. Me give them where them want, me give them. Me give them where them want, me give them. Trust me, me give them where them want. Give
yeah, the man say me give them where them want. We have a headline in front of me. Did Pope Francis support killings and kidnappings during Argentina's brutal dictatorship? Survivors of the hellish period speak out. A whole lot of people don't know about the Argentina revolution will take place. That was in the 70s, 1970s to 1980s. Well, if atrocity was done, we want to give you an insight into this article we have. But the article said, did Pope Francis support killings and kidnappings during Argentina's brutal dictatorship? So we're going to go and come forward. Yeah. Alicia Comos was 22 years old when 9 men birthed into her home to take her away. It was September 1975, and she was a student activist in the Argentine city of Rosario, a bustling metropolis on the banks of the Paraná River. Cosamesh was beaten, interrogated, and thrown into the basement of a police station, where she remained for more than 1 year. Then she was held in the Villa Devoto prison for 2 years. Her release in 1978 was hardly freeing. She remained under every surveillance, and military officials continued to threaten her safety until she fled to Los Angeles in 1980. Ten of thousands of leftists and activists, Argentine citizens, were either killed or kidnapped by government forces during the 1970s and 1980s. This dark episode has been an object of renewed world attention ever since Wednesday, when the College of Cardinals Papal Conclave elected Argentine Cardinal Mario Bergoglio as the new leader of the Roman Catholic Church. And as you know, said this happened quite a while back. It was a surprise choice. The new Pope is the first ever to hail from South of America, the first to represent the Jesuit order, and the first to take the name Francis. He's known for his devotion to the simple life, for using public transportation, for kneeling down to wash the feet of the faithful, for ensuring the luxurious trappings that might befit his station. But critics of Pope Francis say that 3 decades ago, during a time of ruthless persecution and violence, when Argentinians downtrodden needed him most, Bergoglio, then leader of the Jesuit order in Argentina, turned a blind eye to the suffering of his countrymen and women. Yes, and then it go on to say, Argentina was ruled by a military junta from 1976 to 1983. But leftists and dissidents were targeted and arrested even before that time. A state-condoned terrorist organization called the Argentine Anti-Communist Alliance, or AAA, was established in 1973 and exists under the administration of President Raúl Lastiri and finally Isabella Martinez, under whose watch the organizations committed some of its worst atrocities. after 1976 military coup put General Rafael Videla in power, the human rights abuses continued. He held the presidency until 1981, at which point a string of military men took control until the dictatorship fell apart in 1983. The period under the military junta is now referred to as a dirty war, but some victims take issue with the characterization. Alicia Partner was kidnapped in 1977 from Bahia Blanca, or White Bay, a city name for the body of water in which it sits. She was detained in a series of locations for nearly 3 years before escaping to the U.S. as a refugee. And now people call it the dirty war, but that was the term the military used to justify the killings. It is my little crusade to let people know that for me, it was an extermination campaign. It was not a war of any kind. It was a genocide. So it goes on to say, critics of Bergoglio, which is now Pope Francis, say that he was complicit during these terrible times, siding with the government in an effort to protect himself. Quote, in Argentina, the church was divided. Partoni said, there was a sector that supported the military, and Cardinal Bergoglio, which is now the Pope, belonged to that sector. There are two particular allegations most often made against Bergoglio. According to the first allegation, he was complicit in the detention of two Jesuit priests, Francisco Jalix and Orlando Yorio, and may have even played a role in handing them over to the junta authorities in 1976. The priests were detained for 5 months and tortured before their release. Yorio died in 2000, and Jalix, who now lives in Germany, said he is at peace with Bergoglio, according to the Buenos Aires Herald. And this article go on to accuse the now Pope of non-action, even though it's well known to help the poor and all these things. The article goes, it's a long article, it go on to accuse this Pope of non-action when murders and killing was taking place because of the opposition to the dictatorship government by the people. So that is something to reflect on when we start to think, reflect. But I guess people change according to how change go. So we know, say the news will come up, it's 5 minutes before the news, and there is some things that is on the board here you don't want to miss. We have two interview line up here, I tell you. You know, so we always go to the heat of the matter. Yes, when we are interviewed, we go to the heat of the matter. We don't want to take no second hand news and give the people them. We go way beyond Gleaner and the other one there, Observer and all them things there. We observe the Gleaner and come up with news like that one where we just read a guy like, I don't remember seeing it in another newspaper in Jamaica. And look how long that news is out there. We want to interview a sister about Ebola and how come she didn't catch it, considering she was so close to individual who died from it. All right, don't get nervous. It's not a Jamaica. Is that in a Jamaica? So I know some people out there say, what? You know, your mother said I'm going to interview one Ebola victim. Is that in Jamaica we are talking about? Even though she's a Jamaican still, but don't worry yourself. Don't worry yourself, man. Is that in Jamaica? But before we do that interview there, you know, I will come back with it after the news, you know, is this chick fee thing and the government and the Ministry of Health, we want to tackle it headlong, you know, because some development take place in Jamaica right now that we never did hear about. We never knew about it. Just like how them never inform about the chick V thing and how them did not tell you about, you know, it's only about 30 odd people or 20 odd people have it, when we don't know in our lives. Everybody did know everybody would have it at the time. Now I don't know. Now it look like it have got down little, but some more serious things are happening. some more serious thing happen with the chick beer, you know. More highlight it, you know, because we know you nobody had talk about it, you know. And we want to bring in a lawyer for really talk about it, because this can be a lawsuit against the government. I want to know that, you know, because the people them for know what is taking place and what is not told to them, and how where you don't know we hurt you. People always say, where you don't know now hurt you, where you don't know we hurt you, and we see the hurt. And them never tell me certain things. And we want to highlight the things them that is causing havoc right now amongst the people them, and where them never tell me. You understand? So, as we say, we want to talk to Miguel. We want to connect to Miguel Land, our chief lawyer advisor here at the Steppn Raiser here, that I'm ready. We want to heal up Samantha. We want to heal up Samantha. We have a new lady here now with the policy. Well, it's not new still, but Manique. And Manique, your name? Manique. And we have this virgin here, right here, so in front of me, name O'Neill. And we have a man there behind me, so now, what name? Move from behind me, you know, virgin. I don't like to sit down, only sit down behind me, you know. When they come, I can't turn my neck every time. Yes, I'm saying, sit down right there, so I can't see you. And that's how, yes, sit down with the clock, man. Yeah, that's me. When I look at the clock, I can't see you. Gavin. All right. You know, so I see Gavin all the while. You there a long time, Gavin? And you just a trainee? No. But what if you there 20 years and you just a trainee? How about Javier come take over? Watch it, you know. Watch it. And they put in that just when we are celebrating 2 years of Steppn Raiser. Today is 2 years since Steppn Raiser they've had the radio. Exactly. Today, exactly 2 years. And we see them put you in the studio with me, you know. I get suspicious, you know. I forgot to talk to the lady upstairs, you know. The lady upstairs. I don't know where she's going. It's like she's like, yeah, all right. But I put it not that way. Anyway, as I say, we'll come forward to the news. So, news time. I give him a prize, Rasta.
No, man, we have more, man.
You have more?
No, man, we wouldn't give away everything. We have more, man.
All right, sir. Okay. We're there with you again. Steppn Raiser, the art of war. If I know so much people that drink coconut water, I think I'm going to Rasta. And when people thirst upon the road, them just say, chop and jelly for me now. But me know say Rasta, me know Rasta will not drink no other water but coconut water. I'm serious about it, though. Them not drink no other water but coconut water. So, we did not know say coconut water is, you know, a man say, boy, the only water that go to your heart is coconut water. People say that all the while. But even we are saying, you know, we'll get to the point of the thing. We were told, naively, I include myself in the people them too, because I never hear about this chick thing before, until me go and go start to figure out some things and go investigate something. Me hear some boy right now come like China is part of the whole thing. All right. Them tell you must do this thing. Take a Panadol, drink some coconut water, and go rest. Then now we hear some Jamaican people start go down in them head cup and say, look here, guinea hen weed, good feet, and there you have it. We hear papa leaf, all you have to do is juice the papa leaf. We hear a man on the television and say, boy, him take every herb thrown in back and yard, all the roses him start take to. So people start to take it serious. No, hear my problem with it now. I remember, you know, I am naive to the information. I don't know if the information was given and I was listening. But when I look out there, as she said, this is the case, you know. I wonder if the Ministry of Health know, or the government know, say, in the past 6 weeks, listen to what me I say, you know. Listen to what me I say. In the past 6 weeks, nearly 200 people dead because of the chick V creating a complication with other disease that people have and cause the people them for dead. In other words, what we are now hearing, not when the thing did start up, just like, oh, them never did tell us they must clean up the place until just the other day. Them allocate, must say, $5 million to clean up the place. Them never come up with the cleaning thing until thousands of people. Thousands, me not talk about no hundred, you know. Thousands of people catch a chick V. Then them come up with this cleanup campaign. That tiny thing done gone bad already. All right. I want the minister or the ministry or the government to know that over the past 6 weeks, people are dying. Because we never hear say that death thing are going to go on, you know. We never hear say this chick V thing are going to lead to death, you know. Because if we were prepared for the dead part of it, we would have made preparation for those who have diabetes, for those who have kidney problem, for those who have asthma, for those who have high blood pressure. We did not, just like how we are here now about take precaution about Ebola on the radio. You know, every time we hear about Ebola, the Ebola don't reach here yet, and it is good that now they are proactive and not reacting to a situation. And we always depend on the government to give us information about things that we are not aware of. So we can't come say to the people them now, they don't know, should I know, say, you don't have diabetes. We can't say that, you know, because the people them are not doctor. The people them look to the doctor for information. If the government, who is responsible for the people them, did not give out those information to the people them, this almost come like genocide. And we are going to use that word there. Non-apologetically. It's almost like a genocide against the people of Jamaica. Because the government wait until the thing take over the whole of the country. Then them start to tell you to must clean up your place. Then your doctor say, well, just drink some coconut water and lay down your yard and them thing there. You tell me, say, no member in the Ministry of Health in the early times of this thing come in couldn't send out a memo to the radio station them. Some ad on the radio and TV say, if you have complications of diabetes, because now we are here about that, you know, but against a reaction to the situation now, because people are dying because them go catch chick V and them did have diabetes and it create complications. Now remember what school, you remember how we school the people them come from, where most of two teachers dead from chick V and them did have some other complication, and some student dead from chick V, and they did have complication. Well, I tell the minister, you know, and nobody tell me, say, where me get that from, you know. Me say to the ministry and to the government that nearly 200 people dead in a Jamaica because them catch chick V and them have other complication, and they never tell and make the people them aware, say, it's not just a matter of taking a Panadol and go drink coconut water and lay down. It's more than that. It's just the other day on the start to tell the people them now, say, boy, you see this thing here? I don't even know what people know. Say, the pain in them leg and the muscle pain that them have can last up to 1 to 2 years. Watch it. And my producer looks surprised because she never hear that as an information. My producer never hear that as an information. How much people out there know, say, the pain where you feel right? My Virginia O'Neill said, so I said, boy, when he get up a morning time, him forget about the chick V, you know, when he get up a morning time, he can't hardly move him on. All right. How much people in Jamaica didn't know, say, that this thing going to lead to a long-term effect, 1-2 years down the line, where you can't hardly lift up your hand, they can like have arthritis now. How much people didn't know that in Jamaica? You tell me, say the Ministry of Health never know nobody in the ministry to give the people them this information that now families in Jamaica lose them loved ones because all them did feel say is that something them never get over because them take a Panadol and I straight out the thing. And now we see woman lose them husband, children dying, and is the chick V complication that caused it in relationship to some disease with them they didn't have, where the government, I mean, I have to say the government, you know, because the people, they rely upon the government for this information, not no individual doctor, it's the government. Just like how the government now say them have $5 million for go clean up the place because them realize say them is part of the thing now we need to do something, but them are react to it. And Jamaican people are dead. And we now hear them attack no loud. No, you see them attack about the Ebola now because them frightened now. Them get scared now, you know. One little Nigerian there in our hospital the other day. And him never have no Ebola, but two them look on him as the same Nigerian. All people in a wheelchair we can't walk, get up and run out of the hospital. People have the what them call the thing where them push now, you know? The drip. People draw out the drip and roll out of the hospital because they see the Nigerian are coming to the hospital. I tell you. Eh? It's not a laughing matter, but we have to laugh. It's better we laugh than cry, though, because if we cry, we'll get vexed and go do something we're not supposed to do. We have Miguel. Miguel Land, good afternoon, sir.
Greetings, my brother. Blessings, one love.
All right, I don't know if you hear what we are talking about, that's what you see?
I was listening to most of it.
Oh, you was listening. All right, let me ask you a question now. Given that we, the citizens of Jamaica, is dependent on the government to inform us about something that is not in the interest of Jamaicans and in the interest of Jamaica. For instance, if a flood go lick Jamaica, if a hurricane ever come, the government always say, well, this is the precaution that you must take. Take heed, do this, that. Couldn't we say that the chick V is part of that process that the people rely on the government for information so as not to make the thing get out of hand that lead to death?
Well, firstly, a government has a duty of care to ensure that in its governance that it takes all reasonable steps, all reasonable and viable steps to ensure the safety and protection of its citizens. That's an overriding duty that a government has. To the point you're highlighting now, that the Ministry of Health, clearly, in my humble view and many views that we have heard, both on the road and on the media, is that clearly the government not only responded to the situation late, but they responded in a very laxed manner. And eventually, I don't know if it was a government advisory that went out to say that you take Panadol, you take coconut water and so on, and that is the end of the matter. But certainly the response from the government was one that did not help, in my view, to educate the people to a level to say, well then, if you have other complications like asthma, high blood pressure, diabetes and other ailments, then if you contract the chick V, then you ought to take extraordinary steps in order to ensure that
you have control on these
does
diseases.
Not yes. Complicate things more, yes. And could possibly cause death. No advisory went out in regard to that. Nothing was said, in my view. Nothing was done to ensure we should have had a campaign in the schools, in the colleges, in the churches, across the landscape, in the media, television, radio, internet, and so on,
yes.
To ensure that persons now with other ailments would do something
yes.
Preventable,
yes.
Not something reactionary as what happened in some instances, yes. And which it would appear from what I've read cause death. So I certainly think that the government can be held responsible if it can be shown that persons relied upon their advice,
yes,
acted in a certain manner and said, well, look, drink coconut water, take Panadol,
yes,
and stay home and rest, and that will be sufficient. If persons can show that they acted upon that advice,
yes,
and it resulted in the death of their loved one,
yes,
then certainly,
yes,
they could think of a class action suit.
I better ask you a question. I don't know if you remember that five persons out of one school, I think of five.
Yeah, via technical.
Yeah, dead. Five persons in other school, they're dead. And them, yeah, say it's the complication of chikungunya. And them know them say that two of them did have, high blood
pressure. Have an ailment.
Yeah, have an ailment. Up to, yeah, that point, we never hear say that could have happened.
No, I found it very surprising. In fact, I contracted the chick V and I treated it very, 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 very light.
Yes.
Because my entire household had it and so on. So I figured that the same way them have it and it just passed.
I thought you were going to have it too. Yeah.
Yes, so I just took, in fact, I was glad when I had it and said, well, then, you know, at least I get over it.
Yeah, and I wonder how come I don't have it yet and I don't get over it.
You know, so when I saw that, and so, but when I, because it did not occur to me that anyone could die from it.
I never did think so neither. I never did know that people got dead, Rasta. I mean, I tell you, say, this is something that is serious. And, you know, I don't want to use words loosely, but it almost comes to me like it's a genocide. It's like genocide upon the people, them. That,
right.
It
wouldn't be genocide because we haven't had a mass set of murders. But certainly.
But it comes, if a man did not give you the information to save your life, you couldn't hold him to second degree murder. I mean, how you do it? How you work it at the court?
No, because inaction can be just as much as responsible for a death as action.
Yeah, so what would you charge that person for? The inaction of the person. What would you charge him for?
But in this case, it's not so much the inaction, you know. Remember, they gave you advice.
Yes.
Just that they didn't. They never gave us the full advice.
Yes.
Their attitude was initially, it did not exist. It was the false alarm. It was the people bigging up something which really is not so.
Mm.
So even persons with regard to Chick V that I knew who contracted Chick V was reacting because they said the government says not Chick V, it is a flu-like symptom.
Yes.
And it was when they went to doctor and other places and they said, no, that type of pain that they're feeling is not flu.
Yeah.
We have had flu several times and we have never feel these type of joint pains.
Yes.
And these excruciating pains followed by your headaches and weakness of the body and so on. So, you know, that was it. So the government's behavior could have led to even more persons being affected. And could have led to more persons being affected badly
and dying.
Because we know now
that there's a lot.
It was a light
virus.
Yes.
All right.
So their inaction, in my view, and their advice, and their lack of further advice now to say that those with complications need to either see a doctor or need to take extra precaution before, because this thing now can destroy your resistance, because apparently that is what it has to do.
Yeah, it does, yeah.
Destroy your resistance to a level, and therefore result in the finality of death, etc., etc.
Let me ask you a question. I have been speaking to quite a few people who say, is either somebody in their family dead, as them know somebody were dead, and we ask you what killed them. All of the people them say chikungunya. I said, no man, something else did happen to the youth, so the somebody. Why them dead? So what did happen to them before? And them tell you, say, it's either them that have diabetes or whatsoever. So me I say, no, these families who lose loved ones because of the lack of information, in your capacity as a lawyer, is there any way that these families could take action against the lack of information that did not, was not presented to them, that caused them to not take any action towards this thing?
Yeah, of course. Once you can show in law that you relied upon the advice of the minister of, let us say in this case, the minister or the ministry of health,
yes,
that you relied upon their advice that the cure for chikungunya is Panadol, coconut water, and rest. And let us say a man that has passed, and his wife can show that, well then, you know, that we all as a family, we relied upon that information which was given to us. We took all reasonable steps based upon that information, yet it was only when we realized that he had some sort of complication in the blood and that the chick V seemed to have exacerbated it and caused it death. Once you show that you rely on other people's advice, for example, I as a professional lawyer, and if I advise a man within a legal capacity, and the man rely upon my advice, and things go wrong for him, he can sue me. Because he didn't just rely upon any and anybody's advice, he relied upon a professional person's advice. So it is in that capacity. You're not relying upon a man you buck up down the road who tell us to boil up thirsty and ginger and dandelion and drink and that will cure it. You are relying upon governmental advice in regard to how to react and to treat chikungunya. Now, we would also have to show that it was actually that advice that came out. We'd have to get to the source of it. That whether it was the minister himself or the ministry, we would have to look at all the advisories that they sent out and that they gave on radio, television, newspaper, and so on. And once we can point it directly to them, persons would have a cause of action, in my view.
Well, I want the people them who has been speaking to me on the road, because we're on the road, and people stop me, you know, with the downtown there Sunday, and that thing, people always ask me, so we can't do, because them know people who dead, some of them family dead, uptown, same way, you know, people stop me at the elevator, can't imagine me going at the elevator bank as a conversation, but how come they never know, say, Chick V could have killed people, and for them grandmother, or for them step uncle, or something, just dead so, and the governor, the doctor tell him, say, boy, I think they have diabetes, and him never take care, you know, them way they so, me don't know, if why,
because, in other words, that person would not have died, you know,
no,
because they were managing their disease.
Yes.
Yes, what I mean. So it's not a situation where, I'm thinking now of the type of defense that the government would come about, because they would have to say the person would have died anyway from that particular illness. And once it is shown and said, look, the man had this illness for over 10 years.
And
he has been managing it, he has been surviving and so on.
Just
know?
Like a lady that look after my mother, she tell me of that situation that her husband didn't manage when have fears. It was up and about. She never did know, say, because him have chick V, the same thing where I managed for 10, 20 years, would I kill him instantly?
Yes, you know, that is the situation, because that would be their defense to say that the person would have died anyway. And we could counter that to show that they were managing their situation. They took the government's advice, not realizing that this thing would eat away, even at that disease, eat away any medication for that disease, and could result in death. Certainly, the country relies
and
upon the government.
Yes.
The government has a duty of care, a responsible duty to its citizens to ensure that it does everything reasonable and practical to prevent death of our citizens.
Give thanks, brethren, and give thanks for the advice again. We have to say give thanks. Another way there.
Yeah,
I will see you call you again, but we are going with the Mario Dean thing for the next time, still.
Yes.
All right, sir. Give thanks.
We keep in touch.
Yeah, let's click it. Yes, this is the Steppn Razor. The art of war. You know, so we have a very interesting line of interview for do. Sedeyah Rose She's a Jamaican-born nurse who was among medical personnel who treated the first Ebola case in the USA. She is a Jamaican-born lady, and we want to interview her about her experience being a nurse and treating this Ebola case. Obviously, she never have no fear. And obviously, she's still alive. And the man is dead. So we want to get a feel and an understanding. And this interview is also for the Ministry of Health. Because sometimes them say, we love fight things and not show no solution. Well, nobody can say, Muta, all him do that they have blame this and blame that. Well, what is him situation? What is him solution? Well, this interview is part of the solution. We are going to talk to somebody who experienced this and see what we can learn from this sister, you know, being a Jamaican herself in America. So, in a moment, we will have her. Wait a second, my producer? In a few. All right. So, make quick. We're not playing more music yet.
She's right here.
Okay. Yeah, you know, say, the youth are singing about Panadol because of that him did hear, as a little youth. And Panadol him did hear about. Nobody can tell him that Panadol him did hear about. You understand? And him hear about the mosquito too, jumping out Kalalo. Okay, so, on the line here, we have Miss Rose, who wants to say greetings. Miss Rose, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Mr. Mutabaaruka, how are you?
I am totally okay if you are okay.
I can't complain, sir. Believe me, I would be lying if I do.
All right. All right, your parents is Jamaican or you was born in Jamaica?
Both my parents are Jamaican. I was born and raised in Jamaica, went to high school in Jamaica as well.
Are you serious? How long ago that? I don't want to give away your age.
Well, as fabulous as I look for my age, I'm not ashamed of it. It was 20 years ago.
20 years ago you leave Jamaica?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and you have been living in Texas all this time?
No, I actually relocated from New Jersey to Texas about 7 months ago.
Oh, just 7 months?
Yes.
All right, so what kind of nurse are you now? Are you what kind of nurse? Because we hear about nurses, you know, and different, them have different positions, situations. What kind of nurse are you?
I am a registered nurse. I have a bachelor's degree in nursing. Mm-hmm. And I work in emergency. I've been an emergency room nurse since I graduated.
Okay, and you've been working at this hospital, the Presbyterian Hospital, for how long?
For the past 7 months.
Oh, seven months?
Yes.
Not very long, eh?
Not at all.
And to come to this big explosion, you know, that you are now wanted to do interviews all over the world.
Unfortunately, yes.
Yeah, well, we give thanks that you really accept our invitation to do this interview, because what we just don't want to only hear as a Jamaican that you are a nurse who treated Ebola, but we want to know what is the things them that you did in that hospital so as not to you yourself get this virus, because we hear that a lot of people now is looking about these people is getting the virus. What we want to find out is, oh, when did you know that you had to take care of this Mr. Duncan?
It was just the night that I went to work. I didn't have any knowledge of him or anything about him until I went to work that Sunday night that I was assigned to care for him.
So you didn't have no training about how to take care of Ebola patients or nothing?
Not at all. We've never experienced anything like that. Ebola is something that I have been reading about on my own, so it's not something that we're exposed to on a day-to-day basis.
So when you hear that you have to take care of Ebola patient, what's the first thing come to your mind?
At first, like everyone else, I was like, this is a joke. It has to be a joke. You know that it's not true.
Yeah.
And then as the report went on, I realized that it's a possibility. Then as the night went on, then I realized that it is true. So
what did you do now? I mean, after hearing that you have to take your Ebola patient, what is the precaution that you were thrust into? What did they do to make you now prepare yourself to take care of this patient?
Well, first, of course, you know, as I had mentioned before, that I did prepare my, I cried first, and then I just put, you know, got myself together, and, you know, our protective wear is something that we're trained on that's not foreign to us.
Mm-hmm.
The spacesuit is new because we've never done anything like that.
Yeah.
But regular protective wear, that's something that you do use on a day-to-day basis. Mm. It depends on the kind of patients that you're caring for.
Yeah.
So that's never been anything new to me. So, you know, putting it on and taking it off, I guess I could say that I am a professional at that because
it's
something that you have to do to protect yourself.
All right. So when you put on, all right, the patient, Mr. Duncan, is in his room or wherever he is. You are not the only nurse that was treating him, but was taking care of him. Were you the only nurse? No?
I was.
You was the only nurse?
Yes, I was quarantined with him.
You're serious?
For the whole night, yes. One of the gentlemen who was on the panel with me, he came and assist me a couple times throughout the night, but I was his primary nurse.
All right, tell me, carry through the journey now that you're in this room with this Ebola patient. What are you supposed to do?
Well, anything that he needed, that was, you know, my responsibility as his nurse. Anything that he needed, whether it was medication, assisting him in any way that was necessary, checking his vital signs, just about anything. That was my responsibility.
And then how you treat now, when you come out of that room, what you do when you come out of that room, given that you have on this thing that was exposed to the man inside there, what they don't put on anything on him? Is there something that they put on him? He's just there like ordinary?
Yes.
With his pajama and whatsoever?
Right. I would just take my dirty gloves off, clean my hands with some hand sanitizer, put on fresh gloves. Then I would take my gown off and my shoe covers, change those gloves again, clean my hands, leave the room, and then I would wash my hands with soap and water and remove my mask so that I, as the night went on, I was, you know, doing that, and I would change how I would do it. So I made sure that I never left the room and contaminate the other areas where I had to be.
With the same clothes? You don't leave the room with the same clothes on?
Well, I had the same clothes on because I had my scrubs on the whole night, but just not the gloves or gown or anything that I wore in the room apart from my scrubs.
All right, so is the room is it have compartments where you are here, you take off the clothes here, and how it work? What the room is like?
Just a basic single room, and then because I was in an entire area of the hospital that we were sequestered in, so I had the whole outside to myself, and he was just confined in his room.
Okay. So you could change in a little part and then put on your ordinary clothes and leave.
Right.
You don't have to come back to where he is. There's another exit that you leave out of.
No, not necessarily. It was just a regular area with just his room that I didn't have, that I would go in and out of with just one door, so we didn't have another room like that. But once you walk out his room, you're in that entire area of emergency, yes.
All right. So what was it like now, after you'd done your work, going home to your family or seeing your friends? How were you treated by these friends and family? How did it work?
I left work that morning. My sister was waiting for me because she had to get to work. I made sure I did put on a new pair of shoe covers so that I wouldn't, you know, bring anything into the vehicle. I wiped down the vehicle with some bleach wipes. I had already taken the precaution and quarantined myself.
Mm.
So I didn't pick up my niece from school. I didn't allow her to come back into my room or use my bathroom like she usually would or play in my bed or do the things that she loves to do.
Okay, I had
kept her at bay. My sister, you know, left work early so she could get her. So for those couple of days, I was quarantining myself and just kind of not sharing anything with her or with my family because in the back of my mind, I knew what was happening. Even though it wasn't out yet, but I kind of knew, so I was just taking
precautions. All right.
Yeah.
So, when you heard that he died, what came over you know when you heard that he died? Were you you was there when he died? I mean, at work?
No, I worked that Tuesday night into Wednesday morning, and he died while I was on my way home from work.
Oh yeah.
He passed away. Yeah.
So when you hear that, now what? You started to cry again.
Absolutely.
Wow.
Yes, absolutely. I was hurt because I was really hoping that we could have saved him.
So what did not happen? Why you think he died? I mean, because we have heard of other people getting over it. Why is it so unique to this person that he died and nobody else died?
Well, so many people are dying from the disease.
No, I mean in America at the same time. Because whenever he have his family having it, he was amongst his family. They quarantined his family in the house. They quarantined other people. They was looking for other people who they say might have come in contact with him. You know, you have any other people who came in contact with him dying?
Right, and that's such a blessing. We're very happy that no one else who
died.
Was around
yes.
Yeah, caught that terrible disease. I can't attest to that. I know that my hospital and my colleagues did everything that they could and more to try to save his life, and unfortunately that wasn't the case.
All right, we're hearing of experimental Zima, the drug Zima that is used to help other people. Was there any sign of this drug being used on this man, Mr. Duncan?
I don't have access to his chart because once he left emergency, I was no longer a part of his care.
Okay.
So I don't know what medication was given to him while he was there. Under my care, that's different. But again, I can't attest to that because I don't know.
Yeah, and what happened to you was in quarantine for how long? After he died, how long?
I wasn't in quarantine until the 12th of October. They had me in and then they pulled me back out and said I was no risk, and so I went about my business and I was still using precaution amongst my family and friends, limiting my exposure to people, but I was still going to work.
And
I went into quarantine after I cared for the first nurse who came down with the illness.
Okay, so what happened to that nurse now? Where is that nurse?
She is at home, recovering and doing very well.
She has passed the so-called 21 days yet? She has passed that?
She came out before her 21 days because she was tested a couple of times and they found her to not have the virus
anymore
after treatment. Yes.
Yes. And it seems as if there's something in some people that the virus don't attack them like other people. I don't know. Maybe there's a genes thing that is happening. What do you think about that?
A couple of my colleagues and I, we've discussed that. And we're waiting for the science to prove that otherwise, because that seemed to be the case.
Yeah, that there's some genes in some people. All right. So, the family of this Mr. Duncan, where are they now? Because it passed 21 days, passed over a month now. Where are these people that he was living with when he just landed in from Liberia? Where are they?
They're still here in Dallas. The last I heard, they were just still, you know, struggling to find a place to live. And that's been a problem for them because of the whole stigma.
Everybody afraid?
Yeah, unfortunately, yes.
Well, I tell you that a lot of it don't reach here yet, and people scared. a Nigerian went to a hospital here for some other ailment, and people in chair who couldn't walk, get up out of the chair and run out of the hospital.
I saw the cartoon.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Is that scary? So, tell me, what would you advise given that you were hands-on with this disease, and as a Jamaican sister, What would you advise our government to do in order to prepare themselves and also in really taking care of an Ebola patient? What would you advise them on?
Well, again, you know, just educate the medical team and the medical staff, educate healthcare workers, and give them adequate supplies that they will need. It's, you know, it's not going to be an easy thing. These patients, they do generate a lot of resources, and you know, they're highly infectious, so you just have to educate healthcare workers and give them the resources that they need. Education is really important.
Key. Maybe you should come. Yes. Maybe you should come here in Jamaica and give them some training. No, serious. Maybe you should come here and give them some training. Given that your training was hands-on. I listening to you.
Yes, it was.
Yeah, you never go to the university and get no preps and what. It was hands-on. So that hands-on sometimes is much better than sitting down in a class preparing for it. Because then hands-on, are you still alive? You know, so it was doing something right. You know.
Yes. So thank you.
So I don't know if maybe it's a possibility that you should come here. Maybe the government will want to pay you if you're to come here.
I wouldn't let them do that.
Why not? Tell me. Why?
I don't want to take advantage of my countrymen.
I can't see you reading the news there, but you're reading the news. But, no, I mean, if the possibility arises that someone need your hands on education about this thing, would you be willing to? How long have you not been? Have you been to Jamaica? How long have you been to Jamaica?
I haven't been home now in 2 years.
Then that's a long man.
Yes, it is very long.
So you don't want a holiday, man? A working holiday? You want a working holiday?
Yeah.
I mean, if somebody decides, say, all right, we need the sisters, a Jamaican sister, to give us some hands-on argument, reasoning about the treatment of this Ebola case before it reach here. You know, it's like preparation. I know you wouldn't say no, really. I mean, why would you want to say no?
I guess you're answering for me.
Of course, I'm answering for you because me the possibility can arise. All right, we want to give thanks. Give thanks for your time and your energy for really
respond
to this interview. And I hope I meet you again. Yeah, I say again because I feel like I'm meeting you now. And I know that you're going to, when you're going to Canadian airport now, they ask you, when last you've been to Texas? That's weird.
It's funny that I got my letter from Department of Homeland Security yesterday telling me that I was cleared because I was put on a travel ban since the 18th of October, and they just took me off on the 3rd.
Just travel ban? I mean, go anywhere?
To go anywhere. They had my name at all
the airports.
All the airports.
You see, Rose?
Yes, sir.
Like a terrorist?
It would seem like it.
Yeah, like a terrorist.
I guess you could look at Ebola as,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah, this sister who came back as one of the help in Liberia, she was put under almost like an house arrest, and she refused to stay in her house and tell the government, or tell the New Jersey. And she said she's not staying in her room, so she take bicycle rides for sure. Them said, no, I'm to her. She's fit. You don't hear anything else about her? Have you heard last year about her?
It was last weekend she, you know, was apologizing and stating that she would comply with what was being asked of her because her neighbors were very upset and uncomfortable with the situation.
Imagine. But she's passed 21 days now, though.
She should be.
Yes.
She should be.
Yes. Well, as I said, you know, going through Canada, they ask you this question. When last you been to Texas? So I don't know if people coming from Texas to Jamaica now, you will be asked that similar question. I doubt it, though, but it's something to think about.
I would think so, but again, they said to me if I would want to travel, just make sure that I have that letter in hand.
To say that. Yes. Okay. All right, give thanks, Miss Rose. I really appreciate
you.
It. Give thanks to talk to me. You know what I mean?
Thank you. And you enjoy the rest of your day.
Yeah, man, give thanks. Yes, that was Sedeyah Rose, a Jamaican born nurse who was among medical personnel who treated the first Ebola case in the U.S. You know, his name is Thomas Eric Duncan, and he died. And this was a lady who was looking about him in his room. this was a lady who was looking about him in his room, a Jamaican. We in at the ticker everything, no matter what it is. You have a Jamaican there. You understand? Me I tell you, no matter where they are. And me I bet, you know, there's a virgin in a Liberia right now, a Jamaican virgin, want to come Jamaica for Christmas holiday. And you know, say, can't move. He can't move because there's no flight that I'm going to go up and go anywhere in the world. Yes, yeah, so I'm just stay and just go eat up in room and think about the sunshine. Think about IRFM and all every day. I just chew it to IRFM and get like the Christmas breeze. And that's about. No, you have got two kids at the marks, you know, both Texas, you know. Mm-hmm. Where, how long you been to Texas? Have you been to Texas? Dallas, to be specific. And they've carried out the act diplomatically, too, you know. Yeah. Anyway, we want to say Jamaica, we in everything. And this is one of the cases of Jamaica in the boiling pot in everything. That this sister, you know, is a Jamaican who was taking care at this first Ebola case. Now them say she passed her now. She free now. She not in the quarantine. Ray. You hear that? Anyhow, she ever land at Jamaica airport. Immigration with a half duty immediately. They used to say, come. They say, gee, no, sir. Immediately, half duty. You don't see much immigration send up outside. I said, no, sir. Me not going there. And she did not look about the man and the man dead. Oh, me no, say. I don't send them to that. I don't have to kill you. You think Jamaica is easy? Jamaica is not easy. All right. Somebody sent a text that said, via technical in school where the children died.
Teachers.
Yes, the teachers them died. Yeah, okay, that was the chick reason why we didn't have before. But we're glad so we could have get to talk to the sister, yeah. You know, we're glad so we could have talked to the sister, yeah, for really hear from, yeah, Miss Rose, Sedeyah Rose. Yeah, we're glad to say. We could have talked to her because, trust me, when we get there, when we wanted to speak to her, she was talking to our beloved producer, Samantha. She said, why she really like giving more interview? Because the amount of people we are calling her for the interview, so she not giving more interview. But we have that magic. You know them here? Yes. Samantha have that magic. That when she got to do something, it is done. And you know, said the lady said she's a Jamaican, so you know, said she must hear about cutting edge and running a stepping race and all that. The IRFM, what? Yeah, man. If any other radio show what you want to do is right as well. So we give thanks. Give thanks. Sweet reggae music with a little African flavor. Well, the Jamaican musician them not easy. Rasta, I tell you, Jamaican musician not easy.
You've been exploiting me till today. Surely your fall will be great. Big tree, you're about to fall. For great understanding, how Babylon the great is falling, holder of every foul spirit, spirit fear revealed to you this mystery, kings and queens commit fornication with her, merchants waxing rich as they traded with her, chief exploiter of my nation,
misunderstanding. Persons reaching up unto the Almighty. For in 1 hour the children are. Do you remember all the?
Yeah, the time is 4 o'clock, and this is the Steppin' Razor, the art of war. Okay, here we go. Yes. Step in. Yes, sir.
Yeah, Mutabaaruka, how are you doing?
I'm okay, sir.
Good. I just want to say a few things in about 2 minutes or so.
Yeah.
A lot of us know for some time, and some don't know yet, that you are truly among the best journalists on here in Jamaica. It might sound funny to some, but you think about that. That interview with a lovely Jamaican nurse, it is an excellent move, eh?
And well, thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Yes, and I hope it makes the newscast this evening. I can't dictate to anybody, you know? I'm just an old retired journalist now. But excellent girl, excellent woman, excellent interview. And as a matter of fact, I was thinking for some weeks now whether somebody couldn't find out if any Jamaicans were involved in West Africa, especially, and Texas too. Because you know, we, as you say, we are everywhere, eh? Good.
It's a good example of that, we are everywhere.
And her manner.
At the front line.
Too.
Yes, on the front yes. line, too. She was on the front line.
Yes, man. And our most fearless, too. You notice it?
Yes.
Courage.
Yes.
Had to be a Jamaican woman. Yes. Now, the final thing is, you and Miguel, when you were talking to Miguel earlier,
yes.
I was getting a bit anxious that he didn't seem to be taking you to where he ended up finally, talking about the possibility of court action, you know, class action in court against the government?
Yes.
All right. So I told Sam, I called Sam and told her to pass on a message to you, and I was giving her 4 words. And I give you the 4 words now that could help you direct a case like that. If the authority, the expert, I'm going to use the word expert too, doctor, lawyer, engineer, whatever, you can claim in court that they misled you with their information, or misdirected you towards, and the other key one now, is misrepresent, a very highly legal word. And another highly legal one is misdirect you. If you can prove all of those, some of those, one of those, then your case is good.
Okay, well...
And I would say the question I asked was good, because, and I would agree with you, it seems to me that a lot of what the government or the authorities did or didn't do bank on those words could be proven easily in court.
In your estimation, what do you think of those three examples you gave, which one of them you think could stand up in a court of law?
It depends. Let me answer straight. It depends on the skill of the litigant and his or her
lawyer,
the defense.
Yes.
Either of them could win, and also the winning case, also depending on the amount of evidence you present, the open-mindedness of the judge, what is happening in society, because judges are supposed to rule based on what's happening around them in the society, to make an example of people and things and situations, and to prevent the further erosion of a bad situation.
Yes.
So it could win easily, depending on the generosity of the judge, his or her knowledge of the law, the research done, and a host of other angles.
Mm.
But to me, what happened in Jamaica could easily win you a case based on what's happening now.
All right, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you.
You go on to the work. Good listening.
Yes, sir.
And I hope that people... practitioners in the force of state, which is journalism, you know, media, will listen, be more careful and subtle and thinking deeply, because a lot of what passes for governance and power, use of power and so on, it deserves to be in court, to be tested in court.
Of course, definitely.
But we're not learning class action yet.
Yes.
In America, it is a commonest thing.
Yes.
But in Jamaica, by the way, Muta, I say one last thing to you.
Yeah.
One of the reasons why we don't sue authority figures, hospitals, ministry, government, etc., doctors, is because we are afraid of authority.
Yes.
I hate to say, but it's a residue of the slave idiom.
Yes.
Afraid of one's own shadow, afraid of, we are too Christian, we are too loyal.
Yes.
We go to work, we don't miss a day from work, and we only 38 years of work, and we get a watch and a handshake, and at the end, yes, and we are happy and we are pleased.
Yes.
So, you go on to your
thing. Yeah, man, give thanks, sir, give thanks.
All of us.
Yes. Step in, razor.
Hey, yo, yeah. Know what you are doing. Or that you are trying to mash up the community. Or that you bring up. You are able to spread right up. Alright, chill.
Don't pick no trouble. Don't start no trouble. You hook up the gun and be a woman that he cuddle. Don't pick no trouble. Don't start no trouble. Then now who swallow up your head, we make it bust like a bubble. Don't start no trouble. Don't pick no trouble. You hook up the gun and be a woman that he cuddle. Don't start no trouble. Don't pick no trouble. And now walk like say you are that bottle. Hey, Mr. Man, tell me what you see. Are you out on the place? So tell me, say you love the streets. When you have the pretty girls, then what are you?
I don't come for harm, yeah. I come for hell. Hungry ghetto youth, them searching for your meal. Got to represent with my lyrical steel. Buckle up my cutlass, gun for me shell. One leg up to a pickle on a wheel. A top of the food right on the buckle field. Beds and reveal. We fly the red, gold and green that are we born. And we no come face that no drama with no mama. And as a rat we a fit boom the marijuana. That's why we can't turn police or informer. Aya we can, aya we grow, aya we banner. Until we see them out the window on the corner. Through them a mess with brother Fred and sister Lana. And them a trouble papa papa mama Tanya. Them bow the wickedest squad, them a two shot man, but the boot man I shall be. With a militant, living a militant, giving a militant love so free. And that imminent style and permanent smack, I chop it down, chopping me. I move to the rhythm and step to the beat and elevate mentally. So I can bring in that musical sound and keep on singing my melody.
Music calling.
Yeah, man, we are mix it up. Me, I tell you, we are mix it up. Yes. Making radio sound different in the daytime, yeah. Yes. Step in.
Heal prosperity.
Ah, blessed man.
Yes, Muta. I just have some words to share with you. I'm a very sharp time. Yes. Words of prosperity.
Mm.
I sabatut a declare Mutabaaruka, a living legend within the old Jamaica. Word, sound, and power within Jamaica industry of teaching the youth, them uplifting the nation.
All right, sir.
I don't want to say it first night on the buzz, but I declare it now.
Yeah.
And when I ask the I-Motor, which honor is the highest honor that the government gives to people certain time of the year when you see them giving out all the governor general? Which honor is the highest honor?
Me no know which one of them. Me no know where them gay. Me no know where them gay in a bridge. Believe you.
Yeah, ask you something, Mounta. Yeah, you get OD yet from the government or the governor general.
You mean overdose? Why them overdose? We know if you
know. But you know what I mean.
Overdose. No, sir. Me a normal Jamaican like you, man. Me get.
Well, here this is our official with the eye now. Mm. We see over the years a lot of people within the Jamaican society that get these honors, the Jamaican merit, the OD and everything. And some of them doing them work. Some of them maybe they're in the office and doing them work. But we know the Jamaican people at the clear motor to get a high honor within our Jamaican society, because it is not like one time when them said Rasta man a black heart man them a hide in the gully. We see Rasta in a parliament, Rasta in a bank,
Rasta on radio.
Everything. So right now, Rasta take a stand. Even Rasta business, the rich man them a try to lick out, meaning that the Rasta man used to have him high tiles to shop right this way, can get a $300 meal. Now, in the uptown, the same high tiles to meal, $2,000 a grand.
Yeah, but you have Rasta man who set up the official restaurant as well, so we can't complain.
Hear this before I go.
Yeah, yeah.
Within the media ever broadcast that there was a Jamaican lady that just interviewed in Texas was dealing with this Ebola.
I don't know, Bridget. I'm telling you the truth. I don't know. And now I'm going to say no, because I don't know.
Well, me, I tell you now, as some of you say, me know a long time, but IRFM does approve to the world, not only the nation of Jamaica, that them is the number one radio station on planet Earth. Because here I know, look how much media house in a Jamaica, and none of them never try to even fly out to interview this lady at a Jamaica. No, man, this thing look bad for them, man. And for so long.
No, it don't look bad for them. I just show them, maybe them never know about it. I don't judge. Watch out. You see, most of the time, I can tell you my thing about that program, you know, when me ask my producer them for. Even though we like hear the normal news, they come out at Dina and Observer, but me always want Samantha and Keshima look for the news where don't reach the Dina and Observer. So it's when me sit on my house. It's when me sit on my house and me go through my computer.
Yeah.
If me see something when me feel such that day, me just call Samantha, call Kabu and say, Kabu, you see that person there, that person there, and that person them want, and no care where them there in the earth. You see Samantha.
Yes.
Yeah. Me don't know where she have. Anywhere. That person that there, she go and go find them before Thursday. You see Keshima? Anywhere, that person there, she go and go find her. So we have to look at it and say, yeah, you know, them way there, it'll work.
And you see the family of IRFM, because I'm not call them no team.
And you know, say, your 2 minutes, or your 4 minutes, or your 5 minutes gone, long time. So we're going to give thanks to the call. Yeah, give thanks to the call, brother.
Living legend, Mutabaaruka, the living legend.
Lad. But I want to tell you something too, you know, it's enough things we say on this program here where them not investigate, where them need to investigate, because all couple months along the line here, everybody are jump up and down about the place. You know, anytime we talk certain things, we not talk, it's like how we are telling them to say, almost 200 people dead from chikungunya, and you don't see that in a no newspaper, you don't see that nowhere, so it might sound like me, I faluted the speak about certain things. Well, it's the same way when we did talk about the chickpea and how much people did have it. You hear the minister come out and say, confirm cases is under 20 yard. When a woman clear out of St. Thomas, we start to know now. But why you look my friend in St. Thomas, you know? Believe you me, mama. Me love you more than how Jesus love little children. You see, when she call and start tell you how much people in a fair area have it, people could have sounds like such a hype up the thing. But it's true, the woman did attack. And the same day when we are talking about the something, the hospital call we text your thing and show us what the minister talk about. Them treat 40 odd cases and more than they set up a try look treatment. So we not just talking because we want to make no trouble, even though we are make trouble.
Because anything we're doing at Jamaica right now, if it's not in line with the government, them fees say you have make trouble. Last night we play a thing about money from the coaching agent, and we had say if the Peter Phillips could have just listened to all that tape there, for sure say when him say there was no other alternative, it's just something where him supposed to say, because that is what it lead to. It lead to there was no alternative. Well, there is other alternative, but you say all them set the program. These people in a them high position, these Rockefeller and Rothschild and Bilderbergers and all of these people control up the world, the scene. You can't see nothing outside of where them set in front of you. You have to be radical like all Castro. Where 50 years them have embargo upon Castro. And right now when you look on Cuba, the healthcare system in Cuba, it's much better than America, where it's a first world country. There's no illiteracy in Cuba. And we know, say, when America sends soldiers go to Liberia, the Cuban them sell doctors to Liberia. The Cuban them send army in Angola. So, it's not, and it's just 90 miles them there from where. So we have to know, say, really and truly, there's something wrong with we. If you continue pursue the line with them while you pursue, when you know, say, it's a little better for you if you study your thing and do what you want to do. You understand? That's how it go. Step in. Click it. Yes, step in razor, the art of war with there with you. You know, we mentioned Bongo Daniel, the passing of Bongo Daniel. Bongo Daniel, nine night will be held at the family home in Freeman's Hall. Well, I know that is taking place, and it's this Saturday, the 9th, and it starts at 10 a.m. You're going to have some, what you call, music by sound system. I think Sizzler Sound System going to provide the musical tribute in the day, and then in the evening, we're going to have the Naya Bingi chanters chanting. So, this is with Bongo Daniel, and then on the Sunday, the funeral will take place at the Freeman Hall Primary School. Freeman Hall Primary School. And that is, the interment will be at the burial at the family plot. Yes, the burial at the family plot. So all of this Saturday, the 9th, family home, Freeman Hall, 10 a.m. in the day, in the evening, chanting. And then on Sunday will be the funeral, and the service will take place at the Freeman Hall Primary School. Okay, so we continue the journey. Continue the journey. Here we go. Yes, step in.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
How are you doing?
I am doing quite okay.
This is Aramuma.
Aramuma, how are you doing?
Good. I'm trying to talk to you from May.
And you can't get to me?
No, I did leave a message. I really want to talk everything on the ear, but...
All right. Don't talk everything on the ear. Because right. I know your business. I'm fast, and right?
Congratulating you on the two-year anniversary.
Yeah, today is the second year. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And the wonderful job you're doing.
Okay, give thanks.
God bless you. And right. Keep up the good work.
Thank you very much, Mama.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. Give thanks.
Yeah.
And no say, I remember no left IRFM. You know, it's too late. What am I getting nervous? No, them ask. How them? Them there behind me. Me carry turn me neck. You know, me neck creak. Remember what me neck creak? The boy right there. You know. Oh, me have chicken fever. Me have symptoms of chicken fever. All of us on behalf. Oh, my neck. Have something to have to turn the whole of my body for you. We have to turn the whole of my body for looking about. Don't be like a chick V. I may have symptoms of chick V. Because my friend, before I said, I can't turn my leg like, you know, like, 180 degrees. 180 degrees. No. I mean, I'm having usually turn 360 degrees my head. Do it at work. Anyway, we have come up to music news right now. You know, the lady have a radio program at the night there, you see. May I tell you, the old village is listening. I tell you this, the old village is listening.
I kid you not, the old village is listening. And it is very wonderful what she's doing in the night, especially for lonely men. Okay, here we go. Before at our time, at 29 minutes, so we can't play the music then. We can't play the music before it. So, make a clip
at this. At what point it became, or he became aware that this gentleman was about to come to Jamaica? Was he traveling here on the invitation of the organizers of the $4 million?
Yeah, the time is 4:30 and it's music news.
Attention radio station.
Welcome. Please back away from your radio. I like new music, news talk, updates with artist drops, listener drops,
sound effects,
and movie drops.
Hey, what's that?
Music news.
Local.
Music news.
International. Welcome to music news.
It's the news time.
Wagwan family, it's Mrs. Keep It Real, your vibes queen, Lady Renee, with today's music news.
Welcome to music news.
It's the news time.
Welcome back to music news. The vibes queen, Lady Renee. Big ups to Muta, Neil, and Tesla in Sweden. Of course, my uncle Azzy Olakin right now. The body of veteran singer John Holt, accompanied by close relatives, arrived at Norman Manley International Airport in Kingston from England yesterday evening. Born in Greenwich Town, Kingston, in 1945, Holt left a massive catalogue of hit songs such as Stick By Me, Stealing Stealing, Alibaba, The Tide Is High, and If I Were a Carpenter. One of Roxette's era's great acts, without a doubt. He is survived by his wife Merle, three sisters, three brothers, and 23 children. Holt's body will be laid at the Dovecot Memorial Park next week. She's no longer on her way. She well on reach. Let me tell you something, man. For the first time in 17 years, a Jamaican female reggae artist has topped Billboard's reggae album chart. Let me give her two clap. Yes, the first week sales of 547 copies. Boy, I tell you, Etana's fourth studio album, I Rise VP Records, leaps from 7 to number 1. The Clive Hunt produced album is Etana's fourth entry on the album chart. The last time a Jamaican female reggae artist topped the chart was like, what, 1997 with Diana King's Think Like a Girl. Now, Etana, who is in the middle of an American tour, which kicked off on October 23, took the time to share this with Music News.
I'll continue the tour until January, then start again in February, and it continues all the way throughout the rest of the year to support this album. I'm receiving a lot of love. I'm seriously happy about this album. I'm happy about all the hard work that was put in by the musicians and myself, and I'm so proud of Clive Hunt. His love for the music is incredible. I love him. One Perfect Love Jamaica. I'm looking forward to your support. Come to Facebook, One Etana, O-N-E-E-T-A-N-A. Like the page. Support a good movement. One Perfect Love.
Yes, auditions are now stirring up for a musical based on the life of reggae legend Bob Marley in New York. Directed by Kwame Kwe Amar, the musical will look at the impact Marley had on Jamaica and the world. More than a dozen roles are up for grabs in this musical scheduled for May 13 to June 14 in Baltimore, Maryland. In addition to Marley and Breakspear, auditions are open for parts of like what, Rita Marley, Marley's manager Don Taylor, Neville Garrick, Marcel Griffin, Griffiths, Judy Mowat, Michael Manley in his 50s, well-known political activist Milton Tony Welch, and Claudius Massop. The next audition is scheduled for November 13. Family, if you're interested, simply type Mali Musical online for further details. All right, Mavada is featured in two songs for the soundtrack to the movie Beyond the Lights, which is scheduled for release by the Relativity Music Group on November 11. So, matter of fact, around the corner, the Sing J collaborates with Trinidad-born rapper Nicki Minaj in both tracks, Give It All to Me and Come On Boy. Released last year, Give It All to Me is produced by JA Productions. It was a hit locally and did well on Caribbean charts on the United States East Coast. The film premiered at the 2014 Toronto International Film Festival on September 7. It is set for a theatrical release of sorts in the United States, November 14.
Your love is bright as ever, even in the shadows.
Yes, and today is keeping it real quickie. Now, with the internet still abuzz from the news that Beyonce, B Queen, the Platinum Edition box set is coming out November 24, a press release sent to me by credible sources, boy, I tell you, a lawsuit is in the making and filed against Queen B. Ahmad, a vocalist, is claiming that B's EXO song, The Big Bad Tune, as a matter of fact, included in the collection coming up, is a ripoff because he wrote a song called XOXO and gave it to a fellow background singer who then must have handed it off to Beyonce herself. Now, he's demanding $3 million. I wish him the best. Now, may I wonder how him come up with that figure there? Like, I don't know in a real life if you actually think you're going to get that amount of money or even get money full stop. You must be sniffing Patek's glue, because look here, you have to go pick some other artist to get money from or a next approach. If you claim, if the claim that you're claiming is legitimate, take yourself out of the public. This is my, you know, two pants of advice. Take yourself out of the public and make it a private legal matter, man. Beyonce, turn around and sue you for libel. Alright. Where to go, what to do? Big Bad Sound Clash happening this coming Saturday. Three the Hard Way Sound Clash, Suicide and Murder. What a title. And the club is keeping that name, Peace Club. You hear what name? Three the Hard Way, Suicide or Murder, and it keeping at the Peace Club. If my love Jamaica one more time. Music News caught up with one of the contenders, Duba from Reggae King Sound. You know, alright, so I thought Jesper had the audio for that, but alright, I'll share the information again. It is happening, as a matter of fact, Braze is a spot, St. Elizabeth Peace Club, and it kicks off on Saturday. $1,000, as a matter of fact, for admission, and we're talking about Ricky Trooper, Reggae King Sound, and many others clashing for the top title, the coveted title of Three the Hard Way Sound Clash, Suicide or Murder. Of course, you can stay tuned to IRFM for more details, of course, because a live interview will happen tomorrow with DJ Sunshine. For more deeds, family, check out Live at 5:45 for Entertainment Spotlight. This has been Music News with me, your vibes queen, Mrs. Keith It Real, Lady Renee.
Yeah, this is, I ever forget all the name of the program. Sure, Auntie, this is the step in the razor. I could tell you last attack on the bike. I tell you. Okay. All right. So, I'm going to ask a question now. You understand? I'm going to ask a question. All right. If you have a man who used to fire a gun and kill people, and him come on the television and I admit saying he used a fire gun, but now him become a Christian and him help gunman who used to kill people to become Christian in him church. I want to know if these people are absolved from the murder that they committed, because they have now turn around them life and is now worshiping Jesus Christ. Because I am realizing that if you're a gunman right now and you want to escape the law, all you have to do is go get baptized in a church and turn Christian. Police not going to find you. Because obviously, man can come on television, tell you same was gunman, was doing terrible things out there. But because him turn a Christian now, him is now a national hero. Because he has now turned around other murderers from the gun and is now worshipping Jesus. I don't know if the church and state mix up right, that's all. But what I'm telling the family of these people that these gunmen killed, Jesus take them into consideration and not the people them who was in was killed. I don't know what's going on. I just ask a question. If somebody use a fire gun, come on the television and tell you same use a fire gun, and him also tell you that there's a lot of man who use a fire gun, who use to kill people, but them turn them life around now and is now Christians, are they still guilty of the crime of murder? Are they absolved from this life of crime because they are now Christians? Because I want to know that seriously, no? I want to know seriously. Because I am thinking on the people them who these people kill. And if it is that, them can just kill people, so, and then get up and turn Christian because the Holy Spirit take them over and then baptize in the name of Jesus. And that is the end of that. They will be charged no more for crime because them was doing that before them was Christian. The police now go find them. So, maybe, all the gunmen them in Jamaica who want escape the law right now and want to stop fire them gun, all in Africa do is turn Christian, baptize and turn Christian, and then nobody will come shooting at you in the garrison them. People now know say who is Christian and who do into that. I don't know how that work, but I just threw it out there. Yes, step in. Yel.
Yeah, Mota, Yel.
Yeah, blessing.
Yeah, man, I can't I interviewed her earlier, the nurse lady.
Alright, I don't know why. Talk now.
Yeah, man, I really interviewed her still. Believe me, because I said.
Wait, what are the bridge? What you sound muffled up like you're muffled up? Me don't know. You're talking.
Are you
talking
now?
Yeah.
Yeah, when I said the interview, they were all the lady earlier, nurse.
Yeah.
Yeah, me I said, read the interview, because me I said, it seems as if even all the chick video, people are not falling up on the job.
Yeah, them fall up and broke them neck.
Yeah, and. As a recent thing, they did in Parliament, they must say like a joke, my runs, they come like a beer joke, I know.
Who did I run joke?
No, man, this thing, they there with one of the ministers, I'm saying, I run a little joke.
Oh, you mean AJ Nicholson?
Yeah, so you can call it a beer joke, everyone for real.
Yeah, well, I don't joke at them, Rasad. Well, yeah. You're the one who will play, so I talk about million man. You know,
yeah,
like,
the one, a big joke, man. What may I say, still say? Last night on the cutting edge. Yeah. When I say the thing they were playing with the money, the theater, they might be able they haven't even seen gentlemen
around. No, no, well you know, you see ceiling get null and void, I don't know. If you go on the internet and find them thing there, you know. Just go in for Shadow 2. Money, yes, and then maybe to come. I don't know. It's long time I had that tape there, you know. We played about 3 times already by the cutting edge over the past
15 years.
But there are people who never hear people. May I say it's interesting?
Yes, yeah, it's a whole heap of people are talking about it. No people are talking about it. And old Peter Phillips talking about it too.
Well, yeah. he need more than needed.
Yeah,
I
so
put, I think that's him.
Yeah, so I need you to go up on YouTube and put in Shadows.
Shadows, yeah.
Two.
Shadows two.
Yeah, and I'm putting in money.
Okay.
Yeah, and see if it come up. If it don't come up, I don't know how you're gonna get it.
Alright, well, let me try that right away.
Yeah, alright, best
money.
Yes. Yes, I know people are calling about that tape the last night, you know. Believe you me. Sometimes you play something over and over, you feel too much people hear it already, but I want to tell you, say, I get more call now since last night about the tape than when I did play it first, about 15 years ago. As a matter of fact, this is the third time I play that tape because I did have a next one about money. When I show you all them kill the leaders, them, including Bob Marley, in the tape. But a years ago, we played them tape there in the 90s, early 2000s, you understand? But it come fresh again, it come very fresh. Yes, step in.
Here.
Blessed man.
Yes, thanks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You put too much full stop in between your language, you know. Get some comma in it.
Wait a second.
No, you may say you put too much full stop in between the word them. You have to put comma.
Okay. I'm on a call from overseas, man. So it's,
yeah.
The clarity wasn't...
No, the clarity all right, man. That's the length of time when you say the other thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, give thanks, Muta. You know what I'm saying? I, man, want to use the opportunity to elaborate on the point pertaining to the effects of positive vibration towards humanity, towards any individual. Because a spiritual nation like Africans who were born in Jamaica have been always seeking to find the spiritual connection towards how is it they can live accordingly to how whatever makes them feel joyful. And it is only because of the mistranslation of information that has been edited and passed on to generations and generations. Why is it this thing has been misinterpreted? Because I and I have to know, say, I and I are by...
What you say them are misinterpreted? What you say they're misinterpreting? You say them overpass generations and they misinterpret. What they misinterpret?
Okay, such as whatever things I and I desire, if you want to actually develop that state of being, it shall be yours. For instance, in the Bible, they may state it as whatever you pray for and believe that you receive, you shall receive.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and it is less within a person recognizing that we have to incorporate the vibration of the desire that you have, because I and I are eternal. I and I are vibrational beings. Okay, if you even look at the definition of the word human being, it shows you that the word being, B-E-I-N-G, also have a simile called God, Jah. Okay, so I and I cannot run from the thing that I and I are Jah in our flesh, because it's only because of people don't want to personally study, or you do have the opportunity to study, but you ignore it. Why is it these information are not readily translated? But I and I as Rasta have always heard Bob sing Rastaman vibration positive during the 90s with the more fire, such as the year Cape Town was imparting upon the nation the manifest the activities of your thinking. Also, I've heard you, Muta, spoken about the creativity of thought. Okay, now, the other day I was standing somewhere and I heard a Jamaican come up, and this man's expression was, "What a mashup yard right now." And I stand up there and hear this man express that a mashup yard. And I'm going to have to start there and look, because I notice we are so negatively conditioned that every time you see some people, they don't recognize the negativity of thought that they have, thought vibration. Remember now, this is not just about you trying to say, oh yeah, think positive. You know, you have to feel the energy of the desire that you have. That's why Solomon wrote it in Proverbs 23, verse 7, as a man thinketh in his heart. Your heart doesn't literally provide thought, but your heart emits that electromagnetic frequency to the universe, to Jah, but Jah I respond to. That's why in James 1, you hear Jah tell us, look not to Jah for anything, because Jah is responding to your vibration.
All right, you want no brethren, hold on, no brethren. You see, all the way I said this, so now, it's going to take a long time for you get round to eat actually where you really was.
Yeah, I'm an
affiliate. So you know, I'm the whole of the program. We're not at school, what do you call it, catch part? I saw cash part time now.
Yeah, you really was. Yeah, but I'm an affiliate.
So you know, I'm the whole of the program. We're not at school, what do you call it, catch part? I saw cash part time now. Believe you me, I'm a car entertain you. She keeps saying.
That's the hour.
Yeah, all so, right. Call me upon the cutting edge.
Trying to get interested.
Wait, no man, call me upon the cutting edge. You will have a longer time upon the cutting edge, yeah? That, right now, call me upon the cutting edge. All right, we have to move, Bridget. We have to move. Yes, may I tell you, the Bridget have enough things to say, don't it? If I have enough things to say, Rasta. I was peeping time that over there, so. All right, so we are lining up for the cash part. We know, say, okay, it's not reached so yet. It's not reached so yet. All right, it's not reached so yet. Make we preach this little, and then so we are going. See, now the brethren go down and I said, then all my same couldn't make me talk a little longer than I play music. I said, you get in a trouble, you know. Brethren, I don't be called it here, sir. Trust me, I don't be called it. Because if you know about it, if me don't, they know, you know, Muta makes it up. Because I said, all the one Muta stays, so I'm talking about me can't talk a lot longer. Me and my play music. The time is 10 seconds to 5 o'clock and we're waiting for the cash part still. Yes, this is the stepping razor. Well, I could tell we last I said something. Believe you, I could tell we last I said something. From 5 o'clock, I said, no, yeah, wait for something to say. And I forget what I'm going to say, no, that's a serious thing. All right. Well, we said this day is exactly 2 years since this program started, and it has got you. Hope so the people them really tune in. And this is a tune where all them said, are you bus tune? Yes. This is a tune where we used to play. Where would it just start? From a youth name.
Feel it, feel it. Can't get me down. We wanna feel it, feel it. You're never gonna take my crown. We wanna feel it, feel it. Can't get me down.
Yeah, yes. Well, we have some instructors inside. You know what I'm saying? Don't go for say the name and then something else take up my vibes or whatever. Say it. A Cali Black. Yes, Cali Black.
No big song I make and still can't get no play. Listen to my voice, yes, it's coming from the ghetto where the ratchet them a snap and the bullets them a echo. Divided by the orange and the green, we bring back the love through the music and the sports and the trees. So much corruption in the air, on
no food for serve and protect them. My people biggest fear them no action, them on the verbs. Yes, he said them on nerves. No people are dead and I'm go taxi wanna search. Me can't calm me nerves, you start dying like birds. Sometime me wanna leave this world. Cause they use them a call out. Nobody na answer them. I'm go see you when you turn gangster. Want to the youth them from Goliath.
Yeah, Cali Blackout of St. Anya, you know. Yeah, man, and that tune I used to play. When we just start, yeah, that's when they just come out.
Answer them on to see you when you turn gangster. Or when them want your support, we are taught to vote. Them a go on like them love it the most. It no feel look strange, we get to you to drive range. It no feel look strange, we get to you to take plane. It no feel look strange, we see a youth who used to wipe car glass. Bust out and be the dance on the lane. Yeah, we want to look and understand. Say your man is just a man. More time we need to spend, we younger need an helping hand. Yeah, look and understand. Say a man is just a man. More time we need the strength. We younger need an helping hand. Yeah, what I gotta do to make some money today? Nothing funny, I'm a mess now stray. Hey, me still a keep it wondering.
Yes, step in.
Yeah, Muta.
Blessed.
Bless up.
I sent him as this and I hear the voice.
Yeah, the taxi man and say, no, if you call me sent him, if you call me right, me. He can then call me Muta, man, be the taxi man.
Then call you Muta?
Yeah, Muta, they call me. Yes, come, Muta, come all right. Taxi.
All right, Muta, so you do?
Me, all right.
Why, the chickpeas look like you still holding the dog out there.
Yeah, man. Because I say when I come Sunday.
Yeah, that
makes sense. The chickpeas have me wicked, Muta.
So you never get to celebrate your birthday good?
Yeah, me celebrate it. You know, I look like I too, me celebrate it. Make it a cup back for me. I'm a sprint it when I made up for 95. That a cup
back
for me, Muta.
Well, them say no. Them say any little thing where they did that before start to accompany you, so.
Yes, Muta.
And them thing, they never tell you. They never tell you all of them something. Like.
No, they never tell you all of them thing, them, Muta.
Yes. So.
Yeah. You know, they never tell you at all, Muta. Because in my district, me can't count too much people have it. About 3 persons have it.
Don't have it.
Don't have it in my district.
Eh?
Yeah.
You know, say them have a relapse thing going on right now. That you, if you know, do certain resting and all them something, you can have a relapse, you know.
Yeah, because about 3 days, me feel like me go dead in a Muta. My daughter said, Mommy, stop work, so. Because you have to do the housework and the yard work, Muta.
But then, if me come down, if about 2 weeks straight, me see you come down, so I appear dancing, yeah, your friend, them depend.
Yeah, Muta.
Me think say, could I work out the cheek V, but it come back
like, no, and dance. It take me more when time to exercise also.
Yeah, you don't know, exercise. They say you don't have no exercise when you have it.
So
how you feel now? How you feel now? How you feel now?
Yeah, me still feel it. Me still a feel the pain, Muta. Me still a feel the pain, but we still a come Sunday a van where I use this time. Both a little bus.
Hey, let me tell you something, man.
Yeah.
Hey, John T, you know, so you could have to go put that thing there in the car park downstairs, you know. I don't know how upstairs I go hold you, you know, Billy, hey, you see last week Sunday, you see last week Sunday?
Yeah.
The place can't, they couldn't talk no more.
No more, everybody I hear about it, you know, can I tell people about it, you know, Muta.
Yeah. So me I tell John T, say, boy, yeah. John T, come like, you have to go put it, you know, that a big car park over the other side of the road.
Yes, me know over there.
Look like so. I over there, say, I have to go put it a little more, but because
yeah, I big up my waterhouse friend them, because me I invite them down a forever young.
So you book up some waterhouse friend down there?
No, me I pick them up and tell them to watch them down the bubbles, mama lead, I have a body.
Wow, a pure woman you talk about. A pure woman you mentioned down there, so you know.
No, mama lead, I was a rasta man.
Mama lead, a rasta man. What a terrible thing that though, because say it's a pure woman you just mentioned. But me know, say, you have some man will come down there and he stand up the whole night. I know why I dance now. I have him in nine pocket. I know how I feel fine in pocket. The man number couple with some lamb pocket. They not drink nothing. And them all the whole night them have the man in their pocket. And the woman them just a dance. So like the woman them not care.
I like we not care, we just a dance. Yeah, right, yeah. Muta, the woman and dance.
Yeah man, come for have fun. Anyway, we give thanks here you come. I will we tell the people them in that center.
Remember me present me, I come never come Sunday to the good night, but remember me.
No, you want to yes, anytime you come there. Anything yes, where you want.
Anything.
No, anything yes, where you want.
Yeah,
I
somebody down at 48 West Street, Muta.
Really, listen to me.
I don't know, nice, down the turn up.
A whole heap of people. Hey, Junior Reed, come down there that night, you know.
Yeah, me and Junior Reed, I bet Junior.
Wait, no, Junior Reed, come down there, son. Junior Reed, say, wait, Muta.
I swear I never come to see
you. Yeah, no, hear me, Junior, hear me, Muta. I saw you go on down here. Oh, hey. Never know there's so much people down down at night time.
Yeah, because I'm living at Balmoji Avenue, I mean, so they power went to it Avenue, yeah. So I know him and him know me.
Me know say about come back, though. Me know say about come back.
Okay, yeah.
I can't believe there's so much people down there that is 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock a man in there.
Yeah, man, Muta, wait, me I tell everybody, so down there go turn up, because we tell them down there nice, so this are the place.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, Muta.
Me go come at same time as going on.
Yeah, man, what, everybody, when the party are going, everybody comes here, you say, yeah, come Muta.
Yeah, no, me there, Belmont.
Yeah, you tell me.
Belmont Academy. So tell me, yeah. So if you come there, me can't stay overnight?
Yeah, yes, Muta.
You have single bed or double bed, which one?
A double bed, Muta.
Double bed?
A queen size.
You have queen... Whoa! You have queen size bed. All right.
Yes, Muta.
All right, Mama.
Yeah, me, I big up the whole Jamaica. Muta, we say.
But wait, are you one sleep on your queen? Wait, let me talk about your bed, man.
I'm a friend sleep on your Janet. Yeah, you Janet.
Then that no nicer then? That, oh!
Yes,
oh,
yeah, I keep my company.
Find the queen size bed. From the queen side bed.
Yes, Muta.
That means you know the two queen them can't sit lay down over that side and me just over the king side. Make me can't see over the king side part because you must have a king side over the other side. All
yes,
right, Muta. Mom. May I look forward to see you, yeah, Mama?
Yeah, Muta, yeah, big up.
Give thanks, yes. Yeah, I'm afraid them. Believe you me, them jolly and nice. They make the place lively at Sunday time, you know? Them come there with enough people. I sent them as them a drive from a Sunday night time, you know, for come to this and drive. 4 o'clock a morning, they drive over because they never said that. But them sweet, man. Them sweet. Okay, which part are they now? All right, click it. Yes. Yes. Step in.
Muta?
Yes.
Happy anniversary. 2 years anniversary.
Give thanks.
Yes, and continue, you know. Yeah. I really enjoy it. And sometimes, I want to tell you your program, keep your sanity sometimes to have one.
Eh?
Yeah, man.
Right,
sometimes we keep your sanity, you know.
All right, Mama. Give
I want to big you up on that interview with the nurse. I want to tell you, you know. But then, I didn't know, so when the lady attacked, when she just started talking, you know, so me start crying. Because I said, boy, me can imagine the fear. Where she have, where she get when time she hears say she have a work with the Ebola man. You know?
Yeah, she said she really did sorry for him too. She sorry for him, you know?
Yeah, me hear yeah, man. Yeah. I real nurse that man.
Yeah, man, I real and a Jamaican too.
Yes,
a Jamaican.
That make it, you know, that make it even better, you know, so we, you know, was a Jamaican.
Right up front, with the right at the tick of the thing all the while.
Yeah.
And even though them, that sometimes it sound like things gone. Even though it sounds like something's last, but you know, so you have something there for all you still. And that's one of the things them where you have for all you, that you hear a nurse where they deal with that Ebola patient and the Ebola patient dead, but she's still.
Ah, she alright.
Yeah,
you know?
She alright. Yeah, man.
They want to me, I call up my friend say, listen to Muta, you know, because here, you my interview with the nurse lady there, you know.
Mm.
You know, I kind of touch him to me, because he's a very sentimental person.
Yeah.
Everything that touch me make me cry.
Yeah, man. That's
I mean, I really watch the news, because too much things go on.
To make you cry.
No, I just want to say to the youth them in Jamaica, say we stop the crime and violence and they take a disadvantage that it are the little thick them like the little boy they were the little man them and you know and all of them thing there. Just let the youth them make them be themselves and stop rape the little girl them and all them something, you know.
All right, Mama, give thanks, yeah.
To the man, them are Jamaica. Make the people them grow up, man. Make them
of course.
Grow.
Make them have fun and know.
Yes,
say,
man. Make them grow up like a
mind.
Child. Make them grow up and stop turning them in a big somebody. Even the parents, them too, you know.
Yeah.
Sometimes at them, you know, because they have your little 6-year-old, you have to take them finger, you have put in your piece in them here, and the little piece of impy skimpy something they will put on the little pick me them. You know, you have turned them in a big somebody before time. Pick me if you grow up as pick me.
Yeah, man. That's true, yeah, that. That man.
Oh, yeah, man.
Give thanks, yeah, Mama.
Yeah, man, right.
Yes, give thanks, man. A true thing. You have some little picnic, you know. Yesterday, man, at a certain place, you believe she had some big woman, you know. And we asked her, how much she was raised? And I said, I'm 13. And I said, the way I do them was a night, yeah. And I said, Muta. And you know, I said, we have to eat food, too. You think that easy? You think that easy, Muta? What you can't do for me? show you don't know what me I go through a date. Mota, what you can do for me?
13.
Eh? 13. What you mean if 13? No, you want to know. Them don't look like 13. But it's when me ask them now. So tell me something. How much you only is? 13. I said, then how you attack it so low? Because them don't want you know still, you know. But you, after a while, you look on them good and you realize them are really 13 for true. But true, them have a whole heap of McDonald's. And the little hat where them call, where them call it, falls here. A hat me call it, you know. Yeah, because me don't really want to get vexed with none of them woman there, you know. So me say, boy, I like your hat, you know. You know, see, your hat look pretty. Because every day, you have some of them change them hat every day, you know. You have some blue hat, purple hat, green hat. And when them put it over them face, them look like Nicki Minaj. They look like Nicki Minaj, you understand? Because Nicki Minaj change your hat every day, too, you know. Yeah, man, so... When we look at it, we say, boy, I like it. After them say, Mota, you can't go on. You know what I mean? Yeah, man. Some of them look nice still, you know? No, some of them look... No, I'm not talking about the 13-year-old, them, you know? Oh. I'm talking about the woman, them, have on the hat. Some of them look nice still, but... You wonder where you work with, you know, because this week you see them in a blue hat. And the next week you come and see them in a green hat. You wonder if I see a lady. Because sometimes you don't know who, you know, some say, you don't remember me. Some say, I don't remember you. I said, they don't me talk you last week. And we say, oh yeah, you didn't have blue hat last week. Yes, Steppn. What that? Roy?
Yes, Pastor, how are you
going? Yeah, man, oh, you turn up your radio to load the whole thing, man. Yes.
No, man, you know what? You can't tell about tougher than a food puncher and car. So, a business place, man, I'm out of the
All right, sir. Where are you now?
Well, I'm proud of you. 2 years. I'm worried 2 years, Mota.
No, 2 years, I'm on this program, yeah. This program.
What about the TV program?
No, them, we don't know what. You got to see them
I
that,
can't
you know.
Pay, can't pay, yeah,
no, man, can't pay me. They don't me the pirate FM. You think me I get paid? Okay?
So, no, can't pay, what? Used to go,
no, see my idiot. My idiot people, they up there, man. Manager people, my idiot. Them don't know a good thing when they have it, man. One, them are idiot. And the, not them, the brother who control them. The
they don't want to be number one, man. That's how TV is there.
And the best thing ever come on for TV, man. And them say that to you, though. But them are idiot. And that be a show, you know. Some really
you know, you know, right now, you're not nominated with so many things I want, right? Oh. And I've met program.
No, you want to know. Me better, me prefer the reward than the award, you know. We prefer have the reward than the award. You understand? Award, yeah. And you can put up on your cabinet and you look at it and say, Lord, you know, when I was that age, I'll get that award for that. But you see, when you have the cash, now you just buy the whole house. You understand? When you get the reward, now you just take it and buy a house and you just feel good. You understand?
For real, Mota, you must say I want a big piece of land on the West Poland, forget it. You must have them, you can't come.
You're serious? You're serious?
Mota,
oh, you doesn't tell me that now. But oh, you doesn't tell me that now.
Mota, but we have to award with something.
No, but me done at Westmoreland Friday now.
Serious?
Yeah, ma'am, you know, they are Belmont, I call me the whole day, Rasta. Serve. I take the bus and come and serve. And then when I go...
Eh? Then I give piece of island float down by the sea, that pass for the hill.
Let's see, no, a girl, yeah, girl, me, no, Bridget.
No, man, no, a girl thing, Mota, man. Mota, tell us something.
Yeah,
Mota,
girl,
you
man.
Mota, you see, I'm not a girl, man. You see, a person like you.
Yeah.
Influence a lot of Jamaicans.
Yeah.
Influence a lot of Jamaicans in this country.
Yeah.
And even today, we did a work and we said, you know what, sir? Channel, I want to get in to call Mota and I call, you know, call Mota today and like, come like, say what? We know in this world, you see me? And I like, we know in that world, you know, but the Regina said, what? Oh, you know, call Mota, man. And
yeah, but you take land, we tell you about the land. What well, me know why you have them land conversation. Them want to know if you have title for the land where you say you give me peace, sir.
I am me, man. I am sitting there, I give peace, sir.
Oh, me are sitting there. Where you can't sit there?
Yeah, man.
Where you say, me are sitting there, I give peace?
See my bed in there, man. You all right.
All right. No, man, me all right. Anyway, I have to go move, though.
No, Mota, you me are
yeah.
Before you cut.
Yeah.
You know, say, I know. Me no bad bet. You say, I know. Portmore, Spanish Town, Mandeville, Savlamar, 12th Street, Russia, Desta, all of them chains still mucky and dirty, not clean out yet, Mota. And it's like that. You have to be with the bigger head of people. Mota, you know, so we can't talk to them, the people.
took the $2 million to reach your side yet. The $2 million they not reach your side.
I guess, oh, we are fighting them with diseases so much, and when you look, round of them places, when them places stuck up same way, you see me?
Yeah.
We're not supporting movements,
everyone. Well, just start the movement and see if any movement will start. Start the movement, Mota. Yeah? Yes.
Mota, what I find, I say, stay strong and do your good thing.
All right, we are going through, Bridget. All right, we have to move now. Yeah, Bridget?
Sabla, man.
Yeah. Yeah, all right, sir. I mean, I look for a piece of land, you know, you could have deal, I look for a piece of land, I think you come back and promise me land, I may not get it. Watch and see. May I get it. Where is it? Adverse, make this all? Go ahead, click it. Yeah, man, may I tell you. All right, so you're what you know. Next week, Wednesday, Steppn Razor, Cutting Edge. We have some people that call it Cutting Steppn, you know, and Steppn Cutting, you know. I may get confused, you know. You can just watch the video of our next program. Would I get dizzy? Would I have told me head back with the program? Anyway, you're right, you know. I done the program almost done. I got, you know, believe you, but you see, we can't take no more phone call because we know I get a long conversation with nobody and then in future we cut them off because we don't like what they must say. Understand? So, to prevent that animosity, we don't take no more phone call. We have to give thanks to the movement, give thanks to Samantha, give thanks to Neil, give thanks to Gavin. All right, give thanks to Gavin. We'll watch everything inside us. So I don't know if them said to me, you have to watch if we are thief, not there. Because a long time, I run down one of them computer, one of them CD player, you know. Anytime we miss a CD player, Mutabaaruka to get out there, you know. I tell you that. All right, here we go.
Mother said that I should leave her alone, but how can I do that when I want her in my home? I've watched her change from toys to boys, and now she's my size. So how could I forget her now when she can share my life? Mommy, I love your daughter. No, just a dream. No one can make me leave her. It's no, just a dream. So you can tell her anything you want, but I'll never let her out of my sight. Tell her how much I'm not her type, but one day she's gonna be my wife. Mommy, I love your daughter. No, just a dream. No one can make me leave her. It's no just a dream. She told me I should wait until her 21. But she's
RFM, number one radio station in the whole wide world.
Drugs and more. John said, Monsie.
smoking, always smoking. Lyrics like a bazooka. You are listening to Mutabaaruka.
Coming from a foreign land, on location in Jamaica, lying there in the sun, rocking on oil and tan. She look at me and asks me why. Why Jamaica so cold?
Time is 5:45 news time.
Live at 5:45.
Good afternoon, it's Thursday, November 6th. I'm Cheryl Johnson.
And I am Primrose Oliver.
From IRFM's News Center, here are the headlines.
Private sector groups question rationale behind NHT's acquisition of a loss-making tourist attraction.
Telecommunications company Digicel expresses concern over the acquisition of Flow by Lime.
Meantime, at least one business analyst says acquisition of Flow by Lime could benefit consumers.
Jamaican-born nurse who treated Ebola patients in the U.S. says proper education of healthcare workers is key to preparing for the deadly virus.
Economic Program Oversight Committee says the country's large debt must be paid off.
And coming up in sports, the West Indies Cricket Board confirms that Richie Richardson has not been sacked as team manager.